guys, Gambino Gamer here. Just doing a real quick pickups video for January 2011. Let's take a look at what we got.
First off, PS3, I picked up Mass Effect 2. Awesome game, really enjoying it a lot. Also picked up Selfie. Awesome working designs game. If you like shoot 'em ups, it's a pretty fun game. Graphic style sort of reminds me of Sapphire for the PC engine, so but yeah, great game. Also picked up Rated 3, classic arcade game. I love the first one, it's one of my favorite arcade games, and went ahead and picked this one up as well. Also, been buying a lot of He-Man stuff, so I figured I'd show that real quick. Down into the basement we go! Yeah. I need to put that Crystal Castles back together. And here's my little extra room that I put all my goodies in. I just picked that up here recently too. I found out about these new He-Man toys and I went like ape shit on buying He-Man stuff. It's ridiculous. I picked that up. I also picked up an original sale from the actual Masters of the Universe show, which is really cool. Prince Adam holding the power sword. I really liked it. When I saw it, I was like, I had to buy it. It's quite expensive, but I didn't pay full price for it. The guy had to, you know, throw me an offer on eBay, and I threw him an offer, and he accepted it. So it was reasonable enough for me. And there's the little sticker that they put on it from Filmation. I don't know if you can see it in the camera. That makes, and it also has it on the back. It's authentic and lets you know all that good stuff. Picked up a little trap jaw here. This thing only cost me $6. It's pretty much a commemorative limited 1 of 10,000. They made it just look like the 81, you know, version of trap jaw. It comes inside its bubble, but it is a replica. And the way to tell is right there on the comic book. It says replica, but other than that, even on the card back, it tells you that it's from 19, I believe 81 or 82. But yeah, when I picked that up, and then the craziness is all these Masters of the Universe. I don't want to go through, you know, each one that I've picked up, but I bought all of these in January. I just went completely ape shit. I got all of them that have been out so far, plus the Comic-Con versions. But I'm just, you know, growing up in the 80s, He-Man was like a big thing to me. So when I found out, you know, that they had these, you know, I couldn't believe it. But it's not just that. I mean, I know they released at He-Man in the 2000s, but it didn't look like the classic line. And these, they took the classic look and just, you know, made them look like modern figures. And it's just amazing. Got Battle Cat down there. So I got this Molar versus Skeletor. This is really cool. I like this. He's got the tooth in his hand there. It's a, if you've ever seen Robot Chicken, you'd get the skit. And then Skeletor's on the chair with the tooth missing. I thought that was awesome. But, yeah, I mean, I don't know how many I got. It's quite a few. I also got a couple of ones that are signed by the Four Horsemen, the people who actually create the toys. Dude, here's some Toys R Us exclusives, which these are the ones I saw in Toys R Us that, you know, piqued my interest and had me find out about this whole line. Get your He-Man, Superman, and there's a Merman and Aquaman. And what's nice about these is they're actual repaints, so I got suckered into buying them. They're quite expensive. They're $34, which I think is outrageous, but I'm one of these type of completionist people. I want all of them, so I picked them up. And then Skeletor and Lex Luthor right there. But yeah, I also picked up the little Comic-Con Moss Man deodorant. Crazy. And then I got a couple of extra figures. I got the Palace Guards. I got Vikor there. And the Goddess is in there. I buy multiples of a couple that I like. Got He-Man right there. That's from the Toys R Us issue. I just like him because his hair is more detailed. I picked up, you know, the old Battle Ram, which is really cool. It actually had the box and everything, as well as the Wind Raider. I got a couple more stuff coming in, but it hasn't got here yet. Then I got a couple of extra figures here. I picked up Vikor, which is the concept He-Man, which is really cool. I can see why they didn't release him, because if you know anything about Masters of the Universe, they got sued by the Conan brand for making this, but that's why they changed He-Man to look like this. which is really cool. But yeah, I got Trapjaw, one of my favorite characters, and Beastman and Skeletor. And the detail on Battlecat is just crazy. That's what I like about these new ones. They look just like the original, but they're a lot more articulated. So, yeah. I've also been picking up Transformer toys. I found out they had these coming out. They like pretty much like the Generation 1 cartoon show. So I had to grab them. Cliff Jumper, Red Alert, Drift, Blur, Cup. Anyone who's watched the old cartoon show from the 80s recognize these toys. They're just, you know, redone, a little different. I also like how they're releasing the Cybertron versions of them. Like, Cybertron Megatron here is really amazing. And you got, you know, Dark Mount and Scourge and Thunderwing, and can't wait for them to release Starscream and all those great characters. But, yeah. That's pretty much it. Thanks for watching. I almost forgot, I gotta show you this because it's so cool. This is one of the San Diego Comic-Con King Grayskulls 2008. It was the first one that was released. And of course, like I said, they had the statue variant, which right there, I got that one too. But I gotta turn the lights off. You gotta check this out. This is so awesome. Ready for it? That's just the coolest thing. I'm just geeking out, nerding out down here in the basement. But yeah, that's just too awesome. I am a Anyway, guys, take care. Put to the test, but it's never enough. You got the touch. You got the power.